our royal fathers, want to appreciate our service commanders, all the service commanders, police, army, navy, federal safety corps, customs, DSS, immigration, prisons, NSDC, and a host of others. Please, let's appreciate them. These are the ones who join hands with His Excellency and then with the prayers of the clergy to guarantee safety of lives and property in Anambra State. May I also welcome the DIG Zone 9 of the Nigeria Police, who are the former Commissioner of Police in Anambra State, DIG Karma, and also AIG Operations at the Federal Headquarters of the Nigeria Police, AIG Taiwo Lakanu. Let me welcome, ladies and gentlemen, the former Governor of Jigawa State, His Excellency, the gangling Dr. Sule Lamido. Please put your hands together for him, ladies and gentlemen. I will have to continue to appreciate all our guests from Nigeria Institute of Architects, Nigeria Bar Association, NDIDE, Boy Scout Association, Girl Guides, National Council of Women's Societies, the judges, and also captains of industry, quite a good number of them. I can see the chairman, chief executive of Juhel Group of Companies, Dr. Eric Okoye, Ide Aglo, Chief Bexo Gwefi, Engineer Otis Anyeji, who is the president of Nigeria Society of Engineers, and also the national president of Sea Matters and Amatas, Chief Dr. Okudelie Zewankwo, the Vice Chancellor UNIZIC, Professor Haneku, Vice Chancellor Paul University, Professor Abanihe, Rector Federal Poly Oko, Dr. Mefo. People from all walks of life. The former Deputy Governor, Engineer Emeka Sibodo. All the teachers, members of Nigerian Union of Teachers, civil servants, permanent secretaries, youth leaders, women leaders, Ndi Anambra, Ndi Igbo, Ndi Nigeria, ladies and gentlemen, please, if I fail to mention your name, forgive me. It is expected that today we will have more than protocol to do. You all gathered here because of the respect and your love you have for our departed father. I want to welcome all of you. And at this juncture, with all due respect and humility, invite His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Anambra State, Abokwedike Agune Chembandibo, Diko Randibo, Ebubedike Ndibo. Ladies and gentlemen, the serial award-winning governor of Anambra State, the new face of the emancipation of Ndibo. Ladies and gentlemen, may I, with all due respect, invite him, Chief Willie, Madabrochukwu Obiano, Abokwedike, Otumba Ataeche of Yorubaland. Yes, he is now paying homage to our departed father and is stepping forward to take his own remarks for this occasion, sober occasion, but because we are celebrating the life and times of this man. Thank you.
Your Grace Emeritus, Bishop Anikwemwa, and all the Lord Bishops of the Anglican Communion, Your Grace, Most Reverend Dr. Valerie Okeke, Archbishop of Onitsha and Metropolitan of the Onitsha Ecclesiastical Province, and the Lord Bishops that are here. I recognize other denominations, the bishops that are here. It shows the unity we have in Anambra State anytime we do things. So I commend you. Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor of Anambra State, Ugobuzwe Nkemokeke, the very distinguished senators, both serving and non-serving senators, I recognize all of you. The members of House of Representatives that are there, I also recognize you. The Speaker, Anambra State House of Assembly, and all the members of the House of Assembly that are here, I recognize you. The Chief Judge of Anambra State, Ezotosi Omar Adipita, and all the judges, it will interest you to note that the court today closed in Anambra because of this ceremony, and all the judges are here. So I recognize all of you. I want to recognize the president of Ohanaeze Ndị Igbo Niile, Dr. Nia Nwodo. Ndị Igwe Igwenu. I will especially recognize the family of our great Ide, Fancha Banua, including Prof. I recognize you, the wives. You know, I'll crave your indulgence to stand on the protocol earlier established by the Comptroller. Ndibai Ekenemunu. We are gathered here today to celebrate a statesman, one of the greatest we have known. Indeed, if history is kind to Dr. Alex Ifeanyi Ekweme, his name should go down as the pillar of modern Nigeria. The facts before us indicate that only a handful of people may have sacrificed as much as Dr. Alex Ekweme to save Nigeria, and much fewer have devoted as much time and rigor to redesigning Nigeria into a workable federation as Ekweme did. Indeed, His Excellency Dr. Alex Ifeanyi Ekweme stands out today as one of the few Nigerians whose life and times graphically reflect Nigeria's attempt to be greater than she is. In Ekweme's outstanding pursuit of knowledge, we are subtly reminded of the importance of knowledge in building a modern society. In his fierce struggle with the military and eventual triumph with his colleagues in G34 to form the PDP, Ekweme underscored the imperatives of entrenching democracy in Nigeria. In the ease with which he sacrificed his personal ambition to be president after being denied the party's ticket in Jos in 1999 and swiftly turned around to support the preferred candidate, Olusegun Obasanjo, Ekweme showed us that Nigeria should always come first before personal or ethnic interests. And in his resolute pursuit of reconfiguration of Nigeria into six geopolitical zone at the 1995 Constitutional Conference, he reminded us that no country can survive without paying attention to issues of fairness, balance, and justice. Again, with his Modotel hotel chain spread across the Southeast, he poked all of us gently in the rib to always remember the importance of Akolueuna. And finally, in his unrelenting support to the government of Anambra State, he tells us that East or West, home is still the best. But he's also emphasized the mantra of our great party that Nka bu nka anyi. Brothers and sisters, I think the point is fully made. I think that we can all see how a great man's life is like a mirror through which his people can see their struggles and aspirations as a society.
through the prism of Ide's life